All right. Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. So my name is Phoebe Vallanos, and I'm Assistant Professor of Industrial Engineering and Computer Science at USC, and also Associate Director of the Center for AI and Society at USC. And on behalf of my team, I would like to present the problem that we have identified in the context of AI and public health. It's the problem of using AI to prevent VL. As Rishab presented yesterday, VL is a huge public health problem. In fact, it's the second largest parasitic killer in the entire world after malaria. Every year, there's about 200,000 infections, and 70% of those cases, actually of the cases that occur in India, occur in Bihar and UP. There is a treatment that's available for treating VL, but unfortunately it's not widely available. It's not easily accessible. The way that VL spreads is actually by means of these sand flies, which can carry the disease and can infect you. There is a way of preventing VL, which is by this indoor residual spray approach. This basically is a spray that we go and place indoors inside houses and can effectively eradicate the flies and so prevent the spread of the disease. The way this is performed is basically twice yearly, before and after the monsoon season. Unfortunately, though, what happens is that we need to have health workers that actually go and do the spraying. And the number of health workers that we have at our disposal, the amount of spray that we have at our disposal are both limited. And also, the spraying needs to occur during a particular time window in the year, and so we have also a time constraint. AI can actually help address this problem. In particular, the way in which we can view this problem, what we need to do is we have a finite number of health workers that can start at a particular village in India, and can for each health worker, we can decide which cities they will visit and the sequence in which they will visit these villages. So this is a vehicle routing problem. Whenever a public health worker visits a particular village, they can conduct the spraying, and we can decide the intensity of the spraying. Depending on the intensity, we will eradicate a certain proportion of the flies, which in turn will prevent a certain portion of the disease from spreading. We have some data already available at our disposal to help inform this decision-making problem. These are basically patient-level data. So we have for both Bihar and UP historical cases, so we can figure out when and where a particular individual was affected by VL. I understand that these people are also tracked in the system, so we can know whether they were cured. We also have information about areas that were actually sprayed in the past. We have patient-level data, demographic information, and so on. And we also have elements that can help, that actually impact the efficacy of the spraying, such as cleanliness of the households, the status of the village, etc. Apparently, if, say, your house is not so clean, then the efficacy of the spraying will drop. We believe that there's some additional data that we could collect that could help inform our decision making even better. In particular, deaths due to VL. So these would be cases that have not been reported at the time when they occur, but that resulted in a death. And also additional data that can help us understand maybe what other factors could affect the efficacy of the spraying, like weather conditions and things like that. What we propose to do is to take this historical data that we have at our disposal, like historical cases of VL, whether the treatment was successful, weather data, etc., to train certain machine learning models that will help us understand where will VL strike in the current year. That will help us also understand the effectiveness and the efficacy of a particular spraying strategy. We will use that information then to inform, to feed into an optimization model that would actually generate these routes for each and every health worker. we're gonna we believe that this approach is very promising. In particular, we believe that by using this data-driven optimization approach, we will be able to improve both the efficacy and effectiveness of this VL prevention strategy. We envisage some possible non-technical roadblocks that we may face. In particular, our proposed approach, because it will be implemented actually by the government, it does require government buy-in. But fortunately, ReShap does have contact with policymakers in the area, so we're crossing our fingers. Some additional challenges relate to dropout rates of these health workers. It seems that every year some of them drop out, in which case you may need to unexpectedly have to retrain health workers to teach them how they can do the spraying. There are some ethical concerns in particular, so we have these basically scarce resources that we're seeking to decide how to allocate. If we allocate them someplace and not somewhere else, we're effectively deciding who to treat and who not to treat, like who may get the disease and who won't. This is a very serious, in my view, ethical concern, and how can we somehow tackle it is maybe not clear. We have, of course, privacy concerns related to the fact that we will be using patient-level data and location, like address information, etc. And at the higher level, of course, one can think about other health priorities to address before this one. And so some concrete next steps. Some milestones that we would like to reach in the next year, I guess. We believe that we can at least solve the technical parts of the project within this coming year. First of all, we would investigate whether these additional sources of data that we believe would be helpful are actually available to us. The second step, which we can start after the first few months of getting started with the project, would be actually this machine learning step of doing these predictions, of predicting hotspots and effectiveness of spraying, etc. And the last step would be actually the optimization step. I forgot to mention this is actually a relatively large scale problem because there's actually 1,000 possible villages that we could be where we could be spraying, giving rise to a huge number of possible routes for the health workers. So we would have to do some work on scalability at least. If successful, this AI-based prevention approach would be deployed by the government. We don't think that there is a need for a particularly fancy like application to share the routes. Instead, this can be shared by just a simple text message or paper-based transmission. We have identified two strategies for evaluating the impact of our proposed approach. First of all, we can go back and track now the a decrease, hopefully, in the new cases of VL for that given year. And then we can hopefully also showcase that maybe we're able to increase the number of houses that actually were sprayed. All right, this is it. Thank you very much for your time and attention.
Okay,
yeah.
We're
going to
have like one question.
All
right.
So I was just wondering, can you just train everyone to spray their own house? Is it
very
hard?
So you would still have, I guess, to get to them the product. So even if they knew how to spray, they'd need to have the tools and the chemicals needed to spray. So you'd have a similar kind of routing problem, right? You need to go and drop this off. Yeah. But maybe actually... now that I think about it, it's maybe a good idea because you can always go and do it earlier. So now you don't have this time constraint anymore. So also you
make sure
have
the drugs reach everybody ahead of time.
Right, you're right.
And then
you're
it could be you could train people. I don't know. Maybe you know better.
In the public health system, this is easier said than done. Make sure drugs are available to everyone.
I see.
But when I think the stock, this was a question that the group member had before we started. Can everyone spray? And there are, it's like, it's not a commercial product like Mortine and all that we use in cities where someone could be trained. And also, there's also whether they will do it or not, right? Because you just leave it to the households, they might not take it seriously. Whereas, as a public health intervention, they would have people who...
Well, I probably, one option would be have a bit of where you try one person to
that might be. So that might be site.
So that's actually an evolutionary model that these guys are following today. It's just that it's planning for two cycles, one before monsoon and the other after monsoon. So of course, village level workers will only know the roots and the houses. So they will be trained. But still is a resource value.
Yes, absolutely.
Because they have malaria, dengue, all the other vector diseases under one person. And it's a short window of 2 months and before monsoon starts.
And I guess while this drops the time constraint, maybe you need more tools, right? You need the equipment as well to spray, which would be more costly. So, and we do have limitations in the amount of product that's available as well. So.
Yeah,